All right, an adult conversation this week for the Curry and Klapo segment.
So you can excuse yourself.
If you're in a committed relationship, is it okay to have a so-called hall pass?
Yeah, so in case you didn't know, a hall pass is when one person gives the other person in the relationship permission to have, you know, a lighthearted fantasy crush with a celebrity. I don't know, but you need to be careful. But this really is kind of a funny conversation
to
think about.
It could be funny, but you could get burned. All right, we got Dr. Josh Klapo, yes. Tony Curry here.
Daryl Hall, is it Daryl Hall count?
No.
You
mean Daryl Hannah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's too busy thinking about his hall pass that he wants to tell the entire world. He can't focus on the
Let's start with the professional.
Yeah.
Is it healthy? Is it okay?
The way you described it in the opening, sure.
Okay.
Sure.
Fun, lighthearted. That's
fun,
funny.
Lighthearted, fantasy. Not really fantasy
celebrities. You touch each other in the
right, exactly. You know. And Linda and I were talking before we went on. It's one thing to say, okay, it's this celebrity and this is who I would be romantically involved with, and you're married and you're like, that's great. But as Linda and I were talking about, what if you actually allow your brain to go to that next step and say, what if this really was happening?
Mm-hmm.
How would I feel if my significant other was intimate with somebody else? And I'm telling you, the second you actually let your brain go there, it goes from lighthearted to...
It should not make any difference, the fact that it's a celebrity. That's what I asked her before we came on. Are we talking about your next door neighbor? Does that count?
Yep.
Or are we talking about celebrity? She goes, no, celebrity. Because a celebrity, you have no
it's
shot.
Unattainable.
It's
unattainable.
Yeah. It's not going to happen.
Except for, like, I was at a wedding one time, and Sheryl Crow asked me if I'd slow dance. And I had to look at my wife and say, do you mind? She's like, you have a shot. I'm like, hey, now...
Don't sell me short, right?
I could have been Mrs. Eric Clapton.
Chad and I, we like to have like a discussion sometimes with our married friends too. It's kind of fun, like just like, you know, a dinner conversation, like who's your hall pass? Like, I know Chad Balios is Taylor Swift.
Right.
And what we're talking about, I'm thinking if Taylor Swift came up and asked to kiss Chad and I was there, a little peck, I would say, sure.
You would, okay.
It'd be good for my career.
Just a cheek thing.
Yeah.
What if he said on the lips?
Yeah, here, this
a
is
a little mwah.
Okay, what if he said a passionate kiss?
Yes.
No.
Okay. Well, there's
that's Taylor exactly. Swift's good at everything.
Let me ask you this, Doctor. But can this lead to an obsession? Like, let's say it's a rock star.
Yep.
And they're like going to every single concert. Is that obsession? Is that crossing the line?
No, what I think is interesting about that one, because you say, okay, well, it's a fantasy, it's a hall pass, and it's not real. But then all of a sudden, your significant other is a huge fan, and they are going to lots of concerts or lots of events, and they're following them around. You do get to this point where you go, is it more than just something light? Are they a dedicated fan?
Or social media, this has turned into a major issue for a lot of people, because you can now contact your favorite celebrity, and if they follow you back, you can DM them.
Mm-hmm.
So if like I'm a DMing Sheryl Crow at 3:00 in the morning, wow, I just caught your show last night in Vegas. It was fantastic. Good luck to you.
Well, look, I've never tried to DM Jessica Alba, but I don't see that happening. She's got like 5 million followers.
She might respond to you. I don't think she would.
But I want to bring this home really quick.
Yeah.
The premise, and if we can remember from I think like 20 years ago when the movie Hall Pass came out, the premise of it was once the guy got the hall pass, he was happy with his wife. Like, he didn't want to use the hall pass.
I like that message.
So,
Decent proposal.
Decent proposal. Yeah. Was it Owen Wilson? He was in the hall pass.
Yeah, quickly,
so,
before you go, ask him who his.
Who's your hall pass? You got to tell him.
All right, okay.
Julie Andrews, all day, every day.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
I will
Dr. Klapo.
Cry when she passes away.
And we mentioned it. It's Jennifer Aniston.
Jennifer Aniston. Of course, I mentioned Jessica Alba. Yeah. In the earlier days, it was Olivia Newton-John.
My hall pass is Devin Booker. I'm a cleat chaser.
Wow.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right, we don't have Megan's mic up, but Megan, just tell us what we'll
repeat
it. It's John Cena.
John Cena!
See how healthy this is?
It's kind of fun.
Look how healthy this is.
Now, Mickey's going to go old school, Farrah Fawcett, you know.
That's okay.
The late Farrah Fawcett.
Yeah,
the late Farrah Fawcett. Yeah.
Speaking of Mickey.
Hey, we're about to have a relationship with, what is it, chicken and waffles?
Chicken and waffles.